क्लैब्यं मा स्मगमः पार्थ नैतत्त्वैरुपपद्यते शुद्रं हृदयदौर्बल्यं त्यक्त्वो तिष्ठ परन्तप. सो इन दिस व्हाट डस कृष्णा से मा स्मगम. सो ओनली द फर्स्ट वर्ड मा स्म मीन्स डू नॉट, गम मीन्स टेक टू. So do not take to what? Klaibhyam. Klaibhyam means unmanliness or impotence. So he uses such a harsh word to wake Arjuna up. Partha. Partha is the son of Pritha, who is Arjuna. Naita tvai upapadyate. Upapadyate means befitting. Na means never. Etat is this. Tvai is to you. So this is not befitting of you. Now he gives advice in the next one. He says, Shudram Hridaya Dorbalyam. Dorbalyam is a weakness. And Shudram is petty. So the petty weakness where Hridaya Dorbalyam in his heart. Tyakto Tishta Parantapa. So Tyakto Tishta is Tyaktva Uttishta. Uttishta means to get up. Tyaktva is giving up. So get up by giving it up, giving up your unmanliness. Parantapa. Parantapa is again addressing Arjuna, which means chastiser of enemies. So the general translation is, O Arjuna, do not yield to this degrading unmanliness. It does not become you. Give up such petty weaknesses of your heart and arise. अर्जुन उवाच कथं भीष्ममहं संख्ये द्रोणं च मधुसूदन इषुभिः प्रतियोत्स्यामि पूजाहावरिसूदन. सो द वर्ड टू वर्ड ट्रांसलेशन इज अर्जुन उवाच. सो अर्जुन सेड कथं भीष्ममहं संख्ये. सो कथम इज हाउ. Bhishma is straightforward. Bhishma. Aham is me. Sankhya is in the fight. So how I in the fight. Dronam cha. Drona also. In the fight do what? Then he says Madhusudana. O Krishna. Ishubhi pratiyotsyami. Pratiyotsyami is counter attack. And Ishubhi is with arrows. So he says Bhishma and Drona in the fight, how can I counterattack with the arrows? Why? He gives a reason. Puja are how? So they are worshipable. Arisudana. Arisudana is referring to Krishna, who is the killer of the enemies. So these people are so worshipable that how can I counterattack them with the arrows? So directly now Arjuna has come to the point that the killing Bhishma and Drona is a problem for me. Guru nahatva hi mahanubhavan shreyo boktum vaiksham apihaloke hatvartha kamastu guru nihaiva Bunjiya bhogan rudira pradigdan. So in this sloka you will see that the way in which it was recited changed. So in Sanskrit the shlokas, what they will say, they'll follow some chandas. It is called the meter. So there are rules for writing it, and in the previous shloka we saw it was anushtup chanda, anushtup meter, and this is trishtup. Okay, so Anushtup is actually constructed 32 syllables, 4 lines. So the shloka will be 4 lines, 8 syllables in each line. Suppose you break it, for example, so in Sanskrit we have to be careful with one thing is when you are breaking. So in the second shloka we saw, Anarya Jushtamaswargyam, then I took a breath, right? When I took a breath, that means it is broken. So after that, in many books, it would have been Kirti Karam Arjuna. But because I took the breath, we broke at 8 syllables and I started, you have to start with Akirti Karam Arjuna. Because Akirti is a word. You cannot say Anarya Jushtam Aswargyam, then Kirti Karam Arjuna. We have to start with that whole word, which is Akirti, not Kirti. So that is why when you take a, if you don't give any pause, it is okay. You can say it fully. But suppose you take a pause, you have to start with that beginning of the beginning letter of that word. So we saw that that is Anushtup and this is Trishtup. Trishtup has got 11 syllables in each line. And in those days, they did not have a highlighter. So when it goes to Trishtup in this Bhagavad Gita especially, that means they are highlighting that sloka. It is an important sloka. You will know then, okay, this sloka is important. So in this also, Arjuna is making quite a strong emphasis here. So that is why it went to Trishtup. So what does it say, this sloka? Guru na hatva hi. Guru, the gurus or the superiors, ahatva hi. Ahatva is not, hatva is killing, ahatva is not killing. Certainly, mahanubhavan, they are great souls, mahanubhavan. Not killing them, doing what? Shreyaha. It is better, he says it is better than killing the gurus for me. Boktum baiksham apiha loke. Boktum is enjoy life. Baikshyam is by begging, api, even, iha, in this loke, life. So for him, he feels that instead of killing great souls like his guru, it is better to beg and to live in this world. And then he goes on to say, hatvartha kaman tu guruni haiva. He says that we are killing them only for artha and kama. Artha is the gain and the kama is the desire. Definitely, eva is certainly. So in this, we are killing our gurus only for artha and kama, which is for gain and desire. Bunjiya bogan rudira pradigdan. So what does that amount to? Bunjiya is one has to enjoy. Bogan is all the enjoyable things. The iha in the previous line we can include here. Iha in this world. Rudra pradigdan. Rudra is blood and pradigdan is tainted with. So all these, this kama and artha things, you are talking about Krishna, that is going to be tainted with blood. Because see, the gurus are noble people. They are great souls. So the general translation is, it is better to live in this world by begging than to live at the cost of the lives of the great souls who are my teachers. Even though desiring worldly gain, they are our superiors. If they are killed, everything we enjoy will be tainted with blood. There are some changes in Arjuna. One thing is Arjuna has become a bit more clear that he says that Bhishma and Drona are the problem. The second thing that we have to notice about Arjuna is that he always talks about enjoyment. The kama artha, I don't want kingdom, I don't want this enjoyment, is very, very conducive for the spiritual path. So he becomes a good disciple. So that one thing we notice in Arjuna, that he has this quality. And he has gone further to say that I'm prepared to even beg. So what does this mean? He has come to that stage of humility. He doesn't even consider himself to be the best archer in the world. He says, I'm ready to beg. Begging is the last resort for a Kshatriya. It is not even the dharma, but he has come to that stage where he is even prepared to beg. So if we talk about begging, the act itself is not the problem. The attitude is the problem. Like a sannyasi will also take bhiksha. Okay, that is also begging. A beggar also begs. So, but what is the difference between the two? Is that the sannyasi is content. If you give him like one cup of rice, he will be content. But two beggars are standing. You give one beggar more and you give one beggar less. They'll almost come to fight with you. How can you give him more? So that kind of a mental attitude is what differentiates the act. Next shloka is also important. It is again in Trishtup. Arjuna goes to the third stage. Now, what was the third stage we are talking about? He goes to the stage where he acknowledges that he does not know. So now here we will examine basically four categories of people. The one who knows, he knows. That is whom? It is a guru. He knows that he knows. He does not need to boast. He does not need to show off. He knows internally. Okay, he is aware that he knows. That person is the guru. He does not know that he does not know. See, I don't know that I don't know. So that person is an ignorant person. He doesn't even know what is there. So he doesn't know anything. He does not know that he does not know. The third type of person is someone who knows he does not know. This is the disciple, Arjuna. He has come to know that I do not know, so I need help. So this is the disciple. This is the best. Then there is a fourth person, someone who does not know, but he thinks he knows. That is the most dangerous. That is the fool. If you say you don't know, that's straightforward. Somebody will come and give you the knowledge. But if you keep pretending or if you keep thinking you know, then that is a very big problem. Arjuna is in the stage where he says, Krishna, I do not know. I am aware of it. So please help me. So this sloka is, Naichaitadvitmakkataranno gariyaha Yadvajaye mayadivano jayeyuhu Yane vahatvana jijivishamaha Devastita pramuke dhatarashtraha Nacha etad vidma. Vidma is knowing. Do we know? Nacha etad. So we do not know which. Na is for us. Gariyaha better. So basically in the first line, it just says, he does not, I do not know which is better for us. Yadva jayema, yadi va no jayeyuhu. Yadva jayema meaning whether we may conquer. Yadivana jayeyuhu is if they will conquer us. So I don't know which is better, whether if they conquer us or if I conquer them. Yaneva hatva na jijivishamaha. But he says, but definitely by killing those people, I would not want to live. Jijivishamaha is want to live. Hatva is killing. Na is never. Vastita pramuke dhatarashtraha. Avastitaha is situated, Pramukhe is in front, Dhatarashtra is the sons of Dhritarashtra. So, but they are situated in front of us. I do not wish to live after killing them, but still I do not know. So, the general translation is, nor do we know which is better, conquering them or being conquered by them. If we kill the sons of Dhritarashtra, we should not care to live. Yet they are now standing before us on this battlefield. So this is a big jump. He has done a breakthrough now. He has gone to stage 3. In all the important shlokas, the next shloka will be considered very, very important. Because Arjuna will surrender in this shloka. Karpanya dosho pahata swabhavah Prichamitvam dharma sammuda chetah Yashtreyasyan nishchitam bruhitanme Shishyasteham shadimam tvam prapannam Karpanya dosha upahata swabhavah. Karpanya means miserliness. That is what? It is in the Upanishads, it will say that it is coming from the word Kripana, miser, but it actually means that the person who cannot take any loss. So Arjuna himself tells that I am of miserliness, of this dosha, this weakness. Karpanya dosha, upahata swabhavaha. Upahata, I am afflicted by this weakness. Of miserliness meaning what? That I am not able to withstand this loss of this Bhishma and Drona. Swabhavaha is characteristic. So I am being afflicted by this weakness, and I have this as a characteristic now. Prichamitvam dharma sammooda chetaha. So prichami is I am asking tvam unto you. Dharma sammooda chetaha. Sammooda cheta means sammooda is bewildered and cheta in the heart. So he is bewildered in the heart regarding what? Dharma sammooda chetaha. So regarding dharma. So dharma here they will interpret it in two ways. One is doing right and doing wrong, the normal translation. And because it is about the metaphysical nature, the other translation will be what is eternal. I am bewildered by that. That is another interpretation to that. So what is nityam and satyam? What is the truth and what is eternal? I am bewildered. Yat shreyasyat. Yat shreyaha. Shreyaha is good. Yat is what? Syat. Maybe. In Vedanta, they will always talk about shreyas and prayas. Two things. Shreyas means good. Prayas means delightful. Example, ice cream, is it shreyas or prayas? It is prayas. It is delightful. But after it goes inside, we don't know if it is shreyas. So it is prayas. So he is emphasizing, they will emphasize the word in Vedanta here, shreyaha. What is good? Nishchitam bruhi tanme. Nishchitam is decisively, bruhi, tell. Tat is that, me, the me is to me. So here they will say that nishchitam bruhi, tell me decisively what is shreyas. Sometimes they will move the nishchitam to shreyaha, and it is also interpreted saying tell me Krishna, what is nishchitam shreyaha? What is the decisive good? So that is also one more interpretation. So tell me decisively what is the truth, or tell me what is the decisive truth. Shishyaha teham, disciple, your disciple, te is your and shishya disciple, aham, I am. Shadi, instruct, mom, me. Prapannam, this is the most important word, surrender. So this word, in second chapter they will start with this word, and in the 18th chapter they will end with that word. And even in the Dhyana Shloka we saw prapanna parijataya. That means what? He is a parijata tree to which people? Only to the people who have surrendered. Prapanna, the same word. Only the people who have surrendered, he becomes a parijata tree. So this is the most important word. The whole Vedanta, the surrender is a very important word. Why? Because surrender is not an act. It is an attitude. And what is the actual meaning of surrender? It means giving up your intelligence and accepting the intelligence of another person is called surrender. Surrender doesn't mean just prostration or just lying down at somebody's feet or something. It's just a physical way of telling that. But in the intellect, if you give up your intellect and accept somebody else as the one who is your guru, the one who is able to impart all this knowledge to you and take their intelligence, that is called surrender. So that is the most important need for to become a student. So here we saw that Arjuna has reached the fourth stage now, that he has totally surrendered to Krishna. Why did he surrender to Krishna? There were so many people. There were also Bhishma and Drona. He could have surrendered to them. But what happens is when the disciple is ready, the guru will appear. The grace will come and people don't need to seek a guru, but the guru will appear. He is under the grace of Krishna. So what another thing we will see is that we should not give advice to somebody when they are not ready. This is the most important learning actually. Krishna waited. All this first full chapter was dedicated to Arjuna. Nothing he spoke. Then he said a few lines and that too only as a friend. Then when he knew that Arjuna was ripe and ready, then he is going to start his advice as a guru. One more thing in this shloka you will see. that you also need, you do not, a disciple need not know what he wants, but you need to know what you do not want. So Arjuna in the shloka will tell what he does not want. So guru can give what each disciple wants, but if you are not clear with what you do not want, then he will not be able to help you. After having surrendered, he says this shloka to say what he does not want. So this is also an important shloka to say that you all should know what you at least don't want. So in this shloka is nahi prapashyami mama apanudyat yachokamuchoshanam indriyanam avapya bhumavasapatnamriddham rajyam suranam apichadipatyam. So nahi prapashyami, prapashyami is I see, nahi prapashyami, na do not, he certainly, I do not certainly see. Mama panudyat, apanudyat is drive away. So he cannot see what can drive away. Yet that shokam, that sorrow, uchoshanam indriyanam. So he is saying that this sorrow is uchoshanam, is drying up. Indriyanam is his senses. So this sorrow is drying up his senses. Avapya bhuma. So he will talk about two things that he really does not want. He does not care about. Avapya is achieving. Bhuma on this earth. Asapatnam mriddham. Asapatnam means without any rivals. Riddham is prosperity. Rajyam, kingdom. So he says that if I get an rajyam without any rivals, there's nobody competing for it, I am not happy. My sorrow is not going to go away. And the second thing is suranam api chadipatyam. Suranam is of the demigods, api even. Adipatyam is supremacy. So if you say, okay, this earth you get unrivaled, an unrivaled kingdom, or you say you get supremacy in some loka, that also, those things are not going to make me happy, Krishna. The essence of this is that Arjuna says, I have nowhere to go. He has surrendered. And Arjuna knows exactly what he does not want. So that only then they are a suitable disciple. So that is a point of this shloka.